Hey folks, Alamantic here. Today, in this video, we're gonna take a little trip down memory lane when it comes to water cooling computers. I've been water cooling computers off and on since the early 2000s. Somewhere around 2001, 2002 would have been when I built my first water cooled computer. Back then, the whole water cooling market, the whole water cooling computer scene was definitely DIY. There was not a whole lot of components available on the market, and most people didn't bother to buy them anyway and just made things themselves. So we're gonna take a look at something because when I was recently cleaning my house, I realized I had not one, but two old water blocks from back in the day to show you folks. Now, the one place that a lot of folks would actually spend some money on a water cooled computer was actually to buy a pre-made water block. Plenty of people made their own, but not everybody did. These are from the folks at Danger Den. Both of these, to my knowledge, are Danger Den Maze 2 water blocks. Now, they're called Maze water blocks because unlike modern water cooling water blocks, they're a whole different animal. Modern blocks have skived fins in them, microfins that allow for large surface area of heat transfer with jet plates to control the flow of fluid through those fins. My current video editing workstation is a water-cooled Ryzen 7 2700X with an EK monoblock on the motherboard and a AMD Radeon Vega 56 with a barrel water block on that. Those both have modern designs for cooling components. These old things, they're a whole different animal. These are called maze blocks because inside of them is literally just a maze. The whole idea back then was that we didn't cut in microfins. Some folks were playing around with it and trying to machine really small passages, but for the most part, we just machined a path into the block or drilled and cross-cut and just did whatever we could to keep the coolant in the water block as long as we could so it could absorb the heat from the processor. The last computer that I remember water cooling was an AMD Athlon, which would have been a Thunderbird series one gigahertz processor. To my knowledge, that was the first processor to break over 1 gigahertz to the market selling it that way. And I overclocked it to somewhere around 1.5, or I think the max I hit was 1.6 gigahertz on water. All the history aside, the whole point of this video is just to show you what the inside of one of these old water blocks looks like. All the pictures I can find are like 600 by 600 pixels. I've got 4K video capability, so why wouldn't I just go ahead and record a video and show you folks what things look like inside of these old blocks? I don't know where the heck the second Maze 2 block came from or what revision it is. The only difference externally that I can see on it is that this second block that I have has a thinner top plate that is soldered onto the main block versus the one that I know I personally ran on my Thunderbird back in the day. We're gonna go ahead, take a torch to it, pop a top off of it, and show you what the inside looks like. As you can see there, the top of this thing came off a heck of a lot easier than I thought it was going to. I thought I might have to pry a little bit, but I got it good and hot. The solder just went nice and soft and boop, pop the top off, no problem. The inside of this block is actually a different design than I ever remember seeing. I was actually really confused because I can't find any notes on Danger Den's website, looking in the Wayback Machine, the Internet Archive. I can't find this design on their website at all, but I am very certain this was a Danger Den block. They're the only company that I personally did business with back then. I mean, you can see inside of here with the water passages, the whole idea, the whole design of this block was just to keep the water in the block as long as we could collecting heat. And that was the way that we generated the transfer of heat from the processor to the water of the coolant. Like a modern water block, we would dump the fresh cool coolant into the center to where the core is of the processor, and then it would work its way out collecting heat as it goes, getting to the out passage. Now, back in this day, one part of this whole process was actually the control of flow. If you were flowing far too much coolant, it was flowing really fast, you wouldn't have enough time in the water block to collect heat. And this is a whole debate. How long should the water stay in the water block? What flow rate should you be aiming for? What size pump should you be using? Because you gotta remember, back then, we weren't using D5 Lang pumps. We were using like fountain pumps for aquariums and for home ponds. You know, the pumps we were using back then are these 110 volt things for the most part. This is a Danner mag pump. This is actually one that I ran with this Maze 2 water block back in the day. For a size comparison, here is this Danner mag pump next to one of my failed AlphaCool D5 Lang water pumps. You can see these things are totally different beasts, and we have come so far in the options that we have now when it comes to custom water cooling. Back then, we would just do whatever we could to cool our processors is basically the moral of the story. We would use heater cores from cars to actually use as radiators because there were very few companies producing specific radiators for water cooling at that point. Things like my video editing workstation are just leaps and bounds above the design of what we used to do back in the day, at least what I used to do. People did quality builds and they paid real close attention to making things nice. But at the end of the day, we just didn't have the components, the parts out there available to us that folks do today. So there's really not a whole heck of a lot of a point to this video. Like I said, I just wanted to show you folks some of this old water cooling, what we used to do back in the day. Procooling.com is where I used to hang out a lot in their forums, in their IRC chat back then, and we used to really heavily discuss all these different topics. Folks would make their own water blocks and we'd talk about how we used to find the flow rates and all these things would play into the way we used to build our systems. Nowadays, I really take for granted how easy it is to just call up PC performance parts and order up everything I need, put together my system in a couple hours, and call it done. It was an interesting time as a teenager just playing around with computers. I hope you found this video interesting and taking a look at these weird old components, or really not weird, they're pretty standard for the old school water cooling stuff, but I think it's interesting. If you found this video interesting, please go ahead and drop it a like. Let me know in the comments down below. Are you an old school water cooler? Do you remember these things? Have you been using these? Do you remember exactly what this water block is? Because the design is different than the Maze 2s I'm used to. And I don't want to go ahead and take this other block apart because I have plans for this actually. Go ahead and let me know in the comments down below. Subscribe to keep up to date with whatever random tech stuff I make. Some more water cooling videos will definitely be coming in the future. Hopefully I'll be building a gaming system yet this year. We shall see. Thanks for coming around, folks. Say bye, Gene.